Let's see what's new on the Monster Mill.
Ooh, look. I got a box. So let's do the classy thing. Let's do an unboxing video. Ooh, yeah. Don't need that. Okay. What do we got? Ooh, I got a bunch of buttons. That's cool. What's this thing? Oh, hey. This is spiffy. Oh, okay. Oh, that's a joystick thing. We got buttons and joystick. That's cool. Oh, yeah, there's a handle in there. Put that on later. Let's see what else is in the box. I got a bunch of red cables. Okay. I got a bunch of blue cables. I got a USB cable. What do we got here? Instructions. Cool. And what's over here? What's this? Is this what I've been waiting for? I believe it is. Oh, look at that. It's our USB thingy. Cool. Yeah, there's our little circuit there. So, we got our toys. Let's hook them up and play. All right, it's kind of late, but I've made some progress. Now, for my monster machine, I don't really need a lot of stuff for my machine, and I'm going to program it up to use the Wingman. But I bought this USB pretty much just to make this YouTube video for all of you. So I hope you appreciate it. But I'll probably use it on a future project. But what I did was I connected up a button and went into the HAL routines. And then I systematically stuck the button on each one. And I kind of went like that to figure out what each one is. And so I ended up recording them all here as to what they were. So I just numbered them starting from this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. These are special functions, and I can't really find any way to use them. And then I found out that this connector for the joystick is the same as these four pins. So it's up, down, left, right, or up, down, left, right. I don't remember which. But I recorded them. So it's this one here would go to X is negative, then X is positive, then Y is positive, and then Y is negative. And if you hook them up that way, it works great. I had just plugged this joystick in and tested it all out. That works. If you get the kit that I got, and I'll put a link down in the description, it comes with 10 of this size button and 2 of this size button. And you just plug them in and off they go. And I was wondering about the difference between the white cords and the red cords. And the only difference is when you get down to the metal clips on the end. Whoop, wrong way. The metal clips on the end. These are designed to fit the tabs for these buttons. The other ones are a little bit larger. They're designed for these. Other than that, this end is the same. So if you're wiring your own package up, box or whatever, and you need longer wires, all you got to do is cut these off, and then you can extend them and solder them or use a butt splice or whatever, and you'll be good to go. But I've got all these mapped out, and I've got all of the codes here, and I'll switch to a screen grab. So now you should be able to see this, and you can see what the layout is. And, of course, I'm going to have all that on the server so that you can download it. And that link will be in the description, too. So now that I've got it figured out, I'll film the section for going in and setting everything up. Yeah, I just figured I'd do an impromptu, just let you know where I was at. So, back to the video. Well, I've been playing with this some more, and I started thinking if you had two of the joystick ports and you plugged them in, you'd end up with 24 buttons. Should be a lot of buttons. And I figured that you would end up with input 0 and input 1 in your HAL file. But the thing is, I open this up. Well, so I've got the post GUI right now. And I copy up the Dragon Rise. Put a second line in there exactly the same. And instead of Dragon Wise, I put in Wingman. All right, tell it go. Then I go and open up the file. And I expect to see an error. I expect to see it say, hey, the Wingman's not plugged in. I don't get the error. And it starts up normally. Okay. Then, if I go and I plug the Wingman in, it doesn't show up in the list. So there may be a way of putting two joysticks in to get an extra 12 pins or so, but I haven't found it. So we're going to go under the assumption that you can only have one in there. And if one of you guys comes up with a way that you can get another one, let me know and I'll do an update in the description, or I'll push out another video. But basically, it's not rocket science here. What I've done is, and let me share the screen here, and I'll show it to you. I just pasted in this little section here and assigned the button names to some HAL UI and then pushed it to some variable. And so what you can do is take my boilerplate here where I've got the button names and I've got some variable, and you can just change out whatever you want. So I've got program run, program stop, program pause, program resume, program step, missed on, missed off, spindle start, spindle stop, e-stop activate, and then I've got the Z plus and the Z minus. All right, so if you've got some other signal that you would rather run than this one, just go into the configuration file and find it, and then put it in here, and then make your variable name, you know, something that would match. Like I've got program-run, or, you know, PGM-run. If you wanted to have flood cooling on, you would make it like flood-on or something like that. Other than that, it's pretty straightforward. You can copy my file, paste it into your custom post GUI, and it should come up and run. It should come right up and do everything. All these buttons should function properly. And at that point, it's just a matter of making some kind of a panel with the buttons and wiring them up. I was going to do that, but I just really wanted to get this video out to you. Everything's up and running. It's all working. If I go ahead and run this this demo right now and set it up, turn it on here. If I plug this into, you know, a joystick position like here, for example, you can see that I've got my x-axis is moving one way. If I plug it into this one, moving the other way. Same for the y-axis. And then, you know, I use the last two buttons over here for Z. So if I plug this in here, see the Z is running. Plug this over here and the Z will run the other way. And so I could plug all the buttons in. And then as far as this goes, I just plug these into the appropriate pins up on here. And the joystick functions. I just haven't gotten around to making an enclosure, and the way the wires are, it's too short for me to just like sit it down and run it, so I didn't hook it up. Sorry if I disappointed you on this video, but it's pretty straightforward. There wasn't a lot of magic to it. So go ahead and play with this and experiment with it. If you have any problems, let me know. I'll try to help you out. And I'm going to get back to work on the panel that I made. I've had a lot of people asking for an inch version, and I probably have about 4 days worth of coding to do on that. So pretty much that's where I stand on that. So, all right. Thanks.